America's Junior Miss was Kim Crosby. Kim was from Missouri. In 1979, America's Junior Miss was Susan Horvath. Susan came to us from Pennsylvania. Who will be America's Junior Miss for 1980? From every state in the union, 50 bright, talented junior misses have flown here tonight to compete for the honor of being America's Junior Miss. And now, live from Mobile, Alabama, it's the 1980 America's Junior Miss Pageant with our host, Ed McMahon, and special guest star, Andy Gibb. Brought to you by Kraft. Good name to grow on, because good food is always an exciting idea at Kraft. Get into condition. Clairol's physical fitness plan for out-of-shape hair. And by the people who bring you delicious, refreshing Coca-Cola and invite you to have a Coke and a smile. And here they are, our 50 junior misses. Gentlemen, Mr. Ed McMahon.
Thank you very much. Welcome to the 23rd annual America's Junior Miss Pageant. I've hosted this show before, and it's great to be back in the heart of Dixie in the city of Mobile. Now, this pageant is important and worthwhile because it emphasizes scholastic achievement above all other qualities and abilities. In the next 60 minutes, we'll be crowning America's Junior Miss for 1980. You know, I hosted the pageant some years ago. They said I was the perfect father figure. What do you think some wise guy in the crew said this morning? I was a perfect grandfather figure. Oh, that hurts. Just a few years ago, I might have introduced our Junior Miss as saying, "Here they are, the future mothers and homemakers of America." But a more appropriate introduction would be now. Here they are, the future mothers, homemakers, artists, lawyers, doctors, senators, and astronauts of America. We've come a long way, haven't we? And just look at our junior misses. Have you ever seen 50 brighter smiles in all your life? I'm sure that out there in our audience are 50 very, very proud families and 50 equally proud orthodontists. Indeed. But getting down to business, tonight's telecast is the grand finale to a year-round America's Junior Miss Scholarship Program. More than 25,000 girls have participated nationwide in the state and local pageants. More than $1.9 million in scholarships have been awarded to them. We'd like to thank all our sponsors, the business and civic organizations, and the colleges all across the country who have made these scholarships possible. And now I'm pleased to introduce to you our 50 state junior misses. Alabama.
Money Key from Jasper, Alabama.
Alaska.
Elizabeth Sophie from Anchorage, Alaska.
Arizona.
Melanie DeSpain from Mesa, Arizona.
Arkansas.
Kelly Duke from Texarkana, Arkansas.
California.
Julie Phillips, Visalia, California.
Colorado.
Marceline Rivera from Lakewood, Colorado.
Connecticut.
Mary Beth Griffith, Weathersfield, Connecticut.
Delaware.
Lori Lodd from Seaford, Delaware.
Florida.
Yolanda Fernandez from Clearwater, Florida.
Georgia.
Julie Bryan from Thomasville, Georgia.
Hawaii.
Pamela Mitchell, Honolulu, Hawaii.
Idaho.
Diane Arnson from Greenfield, Idaho.
Illinois.
Eva Carter from Belleville, Illinois.
Indiana.
Leanne Hollingsworth, Kokomo, Indiana.
Iowa.
Shelly Kirk from Boone, Iowa.
Kansas.
Belva Wilson, Leavenworth, Kansas.
Kentucky.
Kim Cowart, Lexington, Kentucky.
Louisiana.
Betsy Corley, Coushatta, Louisiana.
Maine.
Marcy DePauw from Springvale, Maine.
Maryland.
John Denham, Columbia, Maryland.
Massachusetts.
Nicole Carr from New Bedford, Massachusetts.
Michigan.
Mariana Iannucci, Sterling Heights, Michigan.
Minnesota.
Regina LaRoche, Forest Lake, Minnesota.
Mississippi.
Sheila Terry, Stringer, Mississippi.
Missouri.
Gina Curry from Jackson, Missouri.
Montana.
Janelle Espinoza, Arlene, Montana.
Nebraska.
Marshall Smith, Utah, Nebraska.
Nevada.
Deanna McDonald, Elko, Nevada.
New Hampshire.
Andrew Willett from Bedford, New Hampshire.
New Jersey.
Donna Kane from Pocketock Lake, Wayne, New Jersey.
New Mexico.
Deborah Glibbert from Albuquerque, New Mexico.
New York.
Caroline Lehman from Lockport, New York.
North Carolina.
Diane Barfield, LaGrange, North Carolina.
North Dakota.
Jody Juleson, Flinton, North Dakota.
Ohio.
Kim Bomber, Brunswick, Ohio.
Oklahoma.
Jerry Gay Tipton, Bartlesville, Oklahoma.
Oregon.
Sherry Ashmore from the Dalles, Oregon.
Pennsylvania.
Hey, Terry, New Wilmington, Pennsylvania.
Rhode Island.
Clara Conti, Providence, Rhode Island.
South Carolina.
Sherry Thrift, Westminster, South Carolina.
South Dakota.
Helene Duhamel, Rapid City, South Dakota.
Tennessee.
Terry Phillips, Memphis, Tennessee.
Texas.
Mary McKinney, Texarkana, Texas.
Utah.
Lynn Lambert, Provo, Utah.
Vermont.
Catherine Markey, South Burlington, Vermont.
Virginia.
Kay Keeney from Roanoke, Virginia.
Washington.
Karen Burgum, Beardale, Washington.
West Virginia.
Paige Carney, Scott Depot, West Virginia.
Wisconsin.
Kathy Rulin, Franklin, Wisconsin.
Wyoming.
Christy Grant, Glen Rock, Wyoming.
Well, there they are from every state in the union, our 50 junior misses. America's junior miss will receive a $15,000 scholarship to the college of her choice, and she will be the national representative to all our junior misses. The time has come to announce our 7 finalists. Let's find out whom our judges have chosen. Ah, the all-important envelope. Oh, I'm as nervous as they are. All right, let's see, the first one. Utah's junior miss, Lynn Lambert. Georgia's junior miss, Julie Bryan. Ohio's junior miss, Kim Bomber. Alabama's junior miss. Jersey's junior miss, Donna Kane. Kansas junior miss, Belva Wilson. Florida's junior miss, Yolanda Fernandez. Gentlemen, our 7 finalists. Now, who will bear the title of America's Junior Miss for 1980? Okay, now that we know who our 7 finalists are, let's chat with them briefly and find out a little more about them. First, here's Utah's junior miss, Lynn Lambert. As your favorite personality, you listed Carol Burnett. What do you enjoy and admire best about her?
Well, I think she's a really neat lady because she can take the simple things in life and bring a little bit of humor to them. And she seems such like such a nice lady and just a really down-to-earth person. I think that's really neat for such a star.
Very nicely said. Thank you. Lynn Lambert. This is Georgia's junior miss, Julie Bryan. I understand you're an excellent basketball and tennis player. Now, has your athletic ability helped you or hurt you in social life?
Oh, I definitely think it's helped me. All my family is athletic. My grandfather's a football coach. My mother's a tennis player. And it just, I think it brings out some of your better qualities. It helps you, I don't know, when you can express yourself in athletics. I think you can express yourself in anything, and I just enjoy it.
Thank you. Very nice. Julie Bryan. Hi. Here's Ohio's junior miss, Kim Baumer. Which would you prefer to be, the president or the first lady?
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord. We can't go that high.
No. I don't know. Both have a lot of responsibility. The first lady, I read Betty Ford's book, part of her book, and she had a lot of responsibility. I know that, you know, you have to be on time, which is hard, and you have to, you know, just back up your husband all the way. The president has more responsibility, so I'd have to say the first lady.
The first lady. Thank you very much. Kim Baumer. Alabama's junior miss, Monique Key. I understand that Bruce Jenner is your favorite athlete. Now, if Bruce sat down next to you on an airplane, what would you talk to him about?
First, I'd start talking to him about the Summer Olympics when he won the overall decathlon, the gold medal. I think any athlete that can win something like that with all 10 events has to be a super athlete in every aspect of the word. And I would talk to him about California. I've never been to California, you know, and I'd like to visit there. But basically, I talked to him about the fun and excitement of being in the Olympic Games and then winning a gold medal.
Very nicely said. Thank you. Monique Key. Here now is New Jersey's junior miss, Donna Kane. Which would be harder for you to do without, the telephone or television?
Oh, I'd say definitely the telephone.
Right. You talk a lot on the phone.
I sure do. I always talk to my friends on the phone. And when I was younger, my mother used to say, what kind of disease do you have that you have that strange white instrument coming out of your ear all the time? I love talking to my friends on the phone. And TV, I don't have much time to watch. I guess that's because I'm always on the phone. But
there is this show late at night. There's this show. If you get a minute. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Donna Kane. Thank you. This is Kansas junior miss, Velva K. Wilson. I understand you're interested in a career as a diplomat. Now, where would you like to serve and why?
I would like to be able to serve anywhere that my country would require, because I would be needed, because my services would fit the responsibility that I would have to fulfill. I have no country that I prefer, nor people, because I love all countries and all people and all cultures.
Very nicely said. Thank you. Velva K. Wilson. Now here is Florida's junior miss, Yolanda Fernandez. You come from a family with three brothers and no sisters. Now, what were some of the advantages and the disadvantages of being the only girl?
Well, as the only girl, I got lots of attention from my parents, and being the youngest, I got to take an opportunity of many things that my brothers weren't able to at that time. And disadvantages, I see none.
You liked it all the
yeah.
way? Okay, thank you. Yolanda Fernandez. Our special guest tonight is a recording superstar who has touched the hearts of thousands of junior misses from Alaska to Alabama. Oddly enough, people say we look so much alike that they get confused when they see us. So I asked him if he wouldn't mind wearing a red suit, and he agreed. Ladies and gentlemen, from the first family of pop music, here is the youngest of the brothers, Gibb, Andy Gibb.
Walk into a room, your beauty steals my breath away. When you look into my eyes, I find it hard to find the words to say. Wanna run away and hide.
passion.
I feel so tangled up inside. I should have never let you go. Anyone can make mistakes. But a life without your love is a lie too hard to bear. I don't care who's right or wrong. Only know I love you so. Why did I have to write this song? Should have never let you go. Goodbye. In all this wide, wide world, did I have to find you here? Wish I could disappear. I'll never understand. Should have never let you go.
Thank you, Andy. Very lovely. Tonight, all seven finalists will receive scholarships, and five other special awards will be presented. Any one of the 50 could win. All told, more than $100,000 in scholarships have been awarded by the end of this week in Mobile. I think that's pretty sensational. By the way, if you're interested in the Junior Miss program and like more information, write America's Junior Miss, Mobile, Alabama, 36601. And now for all you armchair judges watching at home, here's our scoring system. It works this way. Five categories. Youth fitness is worth 15 points. Poise and appearance is also worth 15 points. Creative and performing arts, 20 points. Scholastic achievement, again, 15 points. And, very importantly, the judges' interviews, 35 points. Now that I've explained how the scoring procedure works, let's meet our distinguished panel of judges who will be making those hard decisions here tonight. Please hold your applause, by the way, till we introduce everyone, all right? New Jersey's Junior Miss of 1974, Donna Alexander. The executive director and editor of Guidepost magazine, Arthur Gordon. From Inside Sports magazine, Frederick Newman. America's Junior Miss of 1974, and one of the stars of daytime TV's Ryan's Hope, Karen Morris Gowdy, and the chief of ceremonies and awards at the 1980 Winter Olympics, George Christian Ortloff. Okay, now you can applaud. It's time now to meet our junior misses in the area of youth fitness. Now judge each girl on her agility, her enthusiasm, her coordination, her vitality. Vitality, and this is a very important element, how involved she is. And if you like her, then give your favorite 15 points. Now, our seven finalists, so you can distinguish them, will be wearing white outfits. And you'll see another outfit in there that I like. The United States Marine Corps, ladies and gentlemen. We have a color guard from the United States Marine Corps. So if you're ready, let's stand up and cheer as the Junior Misses salute the 4th of July.
Oh, yeah.
America's Junior Miss, Julie Bryan. Ohio's Junior Miss, Kim Baumer. Alabama's Junior Miss, Monique Key. New Jersey's Junior Miss, Donna King. Florida's Junior Miss, Yolanda Fernandez. Thank you very much, girls. I'd now like to present our first special award is for scholastic achievement, and that honor is extra special when you realize that 39 of this year's 50 junior misses are members of the National Honor Society. Tonight's winner is a girl with the most outstanding academic record. Okay? All right. The scholarship achievement award, it's $5,000, goes to Arizona's junior miss, Melanie Despain. Our next special award is called the Spirit of Junior Miss. The 50 finalists vote for their own girl among them, who best embodies the ideals and kind of the meaning of Junior Miss. She's a new friend, but a true friend to all the other girls, and the recipient of a $5,000 scholarship. Her name is, from Washington, Karen Burgum. Okay. Are you all right? Okay. All right, congratulations to both of you. In a moment, we'll continue our search for America's Junior Miss for 1980. For those of you who are keeping score, here's our next competition. It's Creative and Performing Arts Presentation. Now, each girl is scored on her originality, her costume, the setting, and the manner of her presentation. She put it all together herself. So give your first choice 20 points, okay? Our first presentation is Utah's Junior Miss Lynn Lambert. Lynn hopes to bring the joy of music into the lives of many through solo performances, accompaniment, and through teaching. To set the mood for her piece, Lynn especially designed and made the gown that she's wearing. Tonight, she will share a dramatic waltz by Chopin, presenting Utah's Junior Miss Lynn Lambert.
Thank you.
Utah's Lynn Lambert. In this category now, Georgia's junior miss, Julie Bryan. Since the junior miss's experience allows 50 girls to have fun and to make new friends, Julie has chosen a medley from The King and I, beginning with the song, Getting to Know You. Here she is, Georgia's junior miss, Julie Bryan.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you, getting to like you, getting to hope you like me. Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy because of all the beautiful and new things I'm learning about you day by day. Shall we dance on a bright cloud of music? Shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye? Or perchance, when the last of the stars left the sky, shall we still be together with our arms around each other?
Judges, Julie Bryan. All right, judges, Ohio's junior miss, Kim Baumer. As a member of a drama club for the past 4 years, Kim has had the opportunity to study the art form of mime and perfect an original presentation. She will portray a mannequin who comes to life at the witching hour. Done to the music of I Enjoy Being a Girl, here is Ohio's junior miss, Kim Baumer. Kim Baumer, we have four more performances, so you all come back, you hear?
Some of the most beautiful women in the world will compete in the 1980 Miss Universe pageant. There is no other event like it. Compare your scores with computer displays from the celebrity judges. Join hosts Bob Barker and Helen O'Connell with Jane Kennedy and special guest Johnny Osmond from Seoul, Korea, Monday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
Continuing now with our finalists is Alabama's junior Miss Monique Key. Based on the legend of Faust, Hungarian composer Frank Liszt wrote the dazzling Manifesto Waltz. Monique will play on the piano themes from that waltz, which depicts a merry crowd dancing happily on a village green. Alabama's junior miss, Monique Key.
Monique Key.
All right, now, judges, for your consideration, New Jersey's junior miss, Donna Kane. Now, the movie Wizard of Oz has given us all kinds of memories, the scarecrow, the cowardly lion, the woodsman, a girl from Kansas, and especially a beautiful song, Over the Rainbow. Our New Jersey's junior miss has chosen that as her selection tonight in this competition. Please welcome New Jersey's junior miss and Over the Rainbow. Here's Donna Kane.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over that rainbow, sky's a blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Troubles melt like lemon drops of way above the chimney top. That's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? If happy
New Jersey's junior miss, Donna Kane. Our sixth finalist is Kansas junior miss, Velva K. Wilson. In a multilingual interpretation of The Little Red Hen, Velva portrays a scarecrow and narrates the classic nursery tale. She tells the story in the languages of her characters, which are a Spanish hen, a German pig, a French poodle, and a British rat. By the way, she designed and made her props and all the costumes herself. Here is Kansas junior miss, Velva K. Wilson.
Once upon a time, our jolly pretty film lived a tiny red hen in una pequeña granja roja. Her friends called her Matilde, but her children la llamaban mamá, mamacita. One day, Matilde woke up craving una tortilla de maíz, pero ella tendría que cocinarla from scratch. So she called some of her friends to help her. Hair pig, Mamzella dog, Master rat, will you help me pick, clean, and grind corn so that I can make us una tortilla? Well, Hair pig said, wie bitte, ich helfe eine Dame kochen und reinigen? Nein, nie. And Mamzella dog said, ooh, ma chère petite amie, je voudrais t'aider, mais comment elle maintenant? And Master rat said, well, I'd love to help old girl, but we rats must keep up our reputation. So, pobre Matilde tenía que montar, lavar y moler all by herself. Me, con tal fel gâteau, the aroma to none other than Hair Pig, Mamzella Dog, and Master Rat. ¿Y qué buscan ustedes? She said. Hair Pig, you refuse to help me cook. Si yo fui nicht essen. Mamzella Dog, your master called? Retournez à votre maître. Master Rat, oh, I would love for you to eat with me, but I mustn't ruin your reputation. My children and I vamos a comer la tortilla. Vengan, niños. Ciao.
Kansas junior miss, Velva K. Wilson. Our seventh finalist is Florida's junior miss, Yolanda Fernandez. For many years, Yolanda has studied the works of the great piano masters. And tonight, she carries that and plays one of her favorite selections, is Chopin's Fantasy Impromptu. Here is Florida's junior miss, Yolanda Fernandez.
Thank you.
Florida's Yolanda Fernandez. Coming up next, Poise and Appearance, another song by Andy Gibb, right after this. Your grooming and carriage. These are the qualities you and the judges will be evaluating in our next category, Poise and Appearance. Watch how gracefully our seven finalists execute a series of moves using their capes, then award your favorite 15 points. Now, to inspire the girls to the pinnacle of perfection, here's again our special guest star, Andy Gibb. I have three very special awards here. Andy, each girl receives a $3,000 scholarship. I'll give you this one. Let me do the first one. The winner of Poise and Appearance is Virginia's Junior Miss, Kathleen Keeney. Kathleen. Congratulations. Okay, Andy.
Okay. The winner of the Youth Fitness Award is West Virginia's Junior Miss, Paige Carney.
Yes. right, the winner in creative and performing arts to receive a $5,000 scholarship is Maryland's junior miss, Dawn Denham. Okay, Dawn. You want to kiss Eddie again?
Yeah.
Right here. All right. Congratulations to each of you. Okay, who will be America's Junior Miss for 1980? We'll find out right after this. Help us crown Junior Miss 1980, his Junior Miss 1979, Sue Horvath. Talk just briefly about your future.
All right, Mr. McMahon, we all have different things in mind for the future, myself, law and politics, but all of these girls and I share a common goal, and that's simply to be the best we can be.
I think that's a great goal. Would you help me now? Would you get that on hold?
I'd be honored.
Here we go, friends. Oh,
wow. Thank you.
All right, you have one and I have one. We'll read the runners-up first, as always. I think you begin.
I sure do. The fourth runner-up and winner of a $4,000 scholarship to the college of her choice is Ohio's junior miss, Kim Lawler.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
The third runner-up, winner of a $4,000 scholarship is Alabama's junior miss, Monique Key.
Runner-up and winner of a $6,000 scholarship is Utah's junior miss, Lynn Lambert.
The first runner-up, winner of an $8,000 scholarship is New Jersey's junior miss, Donna Kane. Okay, darling. Well, here we are. We began with 50 young ladies tonight. We narrowed it down to 7. And now there are Florida's junior miss, Georgia's junior miss, and Kansas's junior miss. Now, 2 of these girls will receive a $3,000 scholarship. The third will become America's junior miss for 1980, receive a $15,000 scholarship. All right, I am pleased to announce America's junior miss for 1980, Georgia's junior miss.
Pageant was brought to you by the people who bring you delicious, refreshing Coca-Cola and invite you to have a Coke and a smile. Kraft, good name to grow on because good food is always an exciting idea at Kraft. And by Seabreeze Antiseptic, for a tingling clean you'll feel down to your core.
Thank our special guest star, Andy Gibb, all the junior misses, and the beautiful people of Mobile, Alabama, for making our stay so memorable. We'll see you next year for the 24th annual America's Junior Miss Pageant. Good night, everybody. Good night. Thank you. Let's go see the girls.